got a couple of new guys ready to return the kick here. Elric Jones and Todd Pendland are back deep for the Cowboys. That's unusual.
Well, we know their speed.
Yeah, we know how fast they are. Also, Cowboys are not going south to north. They're going north to south here in the first quarter. The left-footed kicker is ready for Texas State. That's Andrew Ireland. And we are set for McNeese Cowboys football. Ireland approaches and boots it. It's going to be a high kick. It'll settle down to Elric Jones at the four. Bobbles it for a moment, picks it up and runs. He is to the 20. 25, breaks the tackle. 30, 35, 40, 45 and out of bounds. Good return by Elric Jones, and the Cowboys will have excellent field position. Interesting that you don't see Franklin or Lawrence back there.
Well, you know, I don't mean to, Whitehead's been a tremendous loss.
Yeah.
Tremendous loss. But we've got some guys that looks like we can just plug in there. That's
I
a
know.
Heck of a return right there. We're not starting from our own 42-yard line. We're almost at midfield on the run back.
So Jones brings it to the 42 where he steps out. Cowboys start first and 10 with Derek Peru. Underneath center, two receivers on the left side. Bush is the tailback, and Mangan the tight end goes in motion left to right. Play fake, Peru rolls right, wants to throw. Now does. Incomplete, looking for Friddle out at midfield. Friddle was well covered on a crossing pattern, and Peru threw it down at his feet. Protected from an interception there, but it's incomplete, sliding away from Emmanuel Friddle.
What you really like to see is the fact that the pass rush wasn't really that strong. He was kind of just biding his time. It wasn't really a sprint out. He
right.
was kind of biding his time going out there, but he didn't get a lot of pressure.
Second and 10, three receivers in the ballgame, two to the left and one to the right. Bush is the tailback. Little wide receiver screen to Carly Franklin left side. He breaks the tackle, gets across midfield. He's near a first down at the 49-yard line. Appears to be a yard shy of first down yardage. It'll be third and one Cowboys. They get the ball in the hands of Franklin quickly out in the left flat. Broke a tackle and got nine.
Just one play that you, it doesn't look like anything, and then it's just stick moves. And it's another play that you run all the time, and you say, well, they've got to eventually figure that one out, and they don't.
Third and one. Peru up under center. Bush is the tailback. Gives it Chris Bush right side. First down, Cowboys, and more as Bush gets about five running to the right side, right between the hash marks. It'll be a first down.
See, that's what Bush brings to the table. And actually, we substituted a lot for Jamie Leonard with Bush.
Mm-hmm.
And Bush had one game against ULL. We had the two top backs on the field, and Bush was the short yardage back. So in that particular aspect of the game, we hadn't lost much.
First down Cowboys just underway. We're in southwest Texas territory at the 44-yard line. Peru up under center, Bush is the tailback, three receivers in the game. Play fake, Peru to throw, sets up, throws far sideline. Caught by Lawrence near a first down as he steps out of bounds at the 34. We'll check the spot of the ball and see if the Cowboys have moved to six again. That's that out pattern that usually we see Fontenot throw, but Peru threw it very well there to Quentin Lawrence, and it is a Cowboy first down.
You know, knock on wood, we've had a lot of time to throw the football right now, and they're going to start getting in a bind and trying to play zone all night, and you've got to get another guy on the line of scrimmage. We've got five offensive linemen.
Just outside the 33, the Cowboys first and 10. Lawrence in motion. Option play. Peru's going to keep, and he's got room. Breaks the tackle, has the first down. Down to about the 21-yard line goes Derek Peru, his first carry of the night, a Cowboy first down.
Peru was the most shot guy in the stadium. There was no 60 in.
Yeah.
There was none. I mean,
he was going to option it in. He stopped.
Yeah.
I got an option off.
Yeah.
They just ran with it. Got the first down, about a 12-yard pickup on the left side at the 21-yard line. Cowboys moving with the first possession of the night. Royals in the early going.
We need to foul that play.
Up under center is Peru. Gives the push right side. Uh-oh, in the backfield. Broke the tackle, lost his helmet, and lost a yard. There's a flag down.
Might be a face mask with
the helmet. It's possible with the helmet coming off. That's a face mask call. As Bush lost his mustard-colored cap,
yeah,
as you would like to refer to it.
Mustard hat.
Personal foul face mask.
That'll
be a first down Cowboy inside the 15-yard line.
When that helmet comes off and the head doesn't fall, that's still a pretty tough whack on that ball carry.
To the 10-yard line it goes. It'll be first and... Is it first and goal? No, it is first and 10, just outside the 10. Cowboys could
conceivably get a first down by about 4 inches. So it would be a long first and goal for the Cowboys, essentially. Cowboys will send Priddle and Franklin to the left. Lawrence splits out to the right. Peru in a shotgun with Bush beside him. Inside give to Chris Bush. Not a lot there. Looks like he may have gotten to the 9-yard line, and he's stacked up.
You know, this is a defense that Coach Lee said is tough to draw diagrams up against. You know, they stack linebackers, and they slant, and they stunt, and they blitz, and everything. Now it looks like on that particular play, they had a free safety back there, but they also had that linebacker backed up almost halfway between the free safety and any, and he's the sideline to sideline guy. So they're doing all kind of things on defense.
Remember when they didn't have a defensive end a moment ago on the options? They may have stunted that guy. That may have been why he wasn't there. Second and 9 from the 9. Peru, play fake. He's going to give it to Franklin around the right end. He's looking for the corner. He's down inside the 5. Where is he spotted? At the 3-yard line is Carlene Franklin on the end around. Good yardage. It's going to set up a 3rd and 2 just outside the 2.
Now we got Bush. Now this is a Bush play. You know, Tom, usually when you stunt, though, you have to stunt somebody back to compensate.
Correct.
That guy, or the strong safety has to come up in that. I really don't know where that guy was a while ago on the defensive end.
Somebody
who was good at planted and somebody didn't go back out. Right?
Somebody who was supposed to be there wasn't, that was for sure.
Yeah. You can out defense yourself if you've got a lot of defenses, or you put something in special for that game.
Big third down play, 3 receivers in the game, 2 to the left, Riddle and Franklin. Lawrence to the right, hanging the tight end, sets up on the right side. Out of the shotgun, Peru. Inside gives Bush near the goal line. No call. And down. This is going to be very tight. It's going to be inside the 1-yard line, and it's going to be very near a first down, and it's going to be very near the goal line.
I'd say he made a heck of a play on that. There's always small plays in a football game. You don't realize how a good play it is. And that was Peru. Rode him all the way in for the goal almost,
right.
and so you didn't know who was going to have the football at the end of the play.
They are going to measure for a first down here. The Cowboys are only about 4 inches away from the goal line, and they need to get about to there for a first down. So this could give them a first and goal, basically the nose of the football away from the goal line.
But you know, Tom, this is one of those plays, if you don't make it, you can't tell your offensive line to go kick a field goal.
Right.
We don't trust you for that.
First down, Cowboys. All right, first and goal inside the 1. This will be an interesting situation for the folks.
Right. I'll tell you what, we're going to run right at them.
I think you are correct. Push. Or could you just let Peru take it in himself on a quarterback sneak?
Well,
they'll do anything.
Yeah, we got Jordy Johnson in, and we also have a tight end. So I'd say right at him, because Jordy basically is another tight end because he's a slot on the other side.
Peru drives it himself. No call yet.
I don't see how they can make that call.
Yeah, I know. It is second down. Cowboys, no gain on the play. It'll be second and goal.
Those officials have to run a long way to try to figure out where the ball ended. I just don't think they can get there.
Second and goal, Cowboys. No score. First possession of the ball game. 11:35 to go. The Cowboys have marched right down the field and are inches away from the goal line here.
Now, Peru's going to get a lot of stuff from his teammates.
Not scoring.
Not having the meat on his body to get that one over.
Peru will step up under center. This time he'll give it to Bush. Left side. Touchdown, Cowboys! Hope break out on the board first. The opening drive of the ball game. Right down the field for the score. Chris Bush takes it over for the touchdown.
I kind of have the feeling and know what the coach from South Dakota meant about a McNeese.
No doubt.
Only thing stopped Bush was the field house.
Yep. Bertha J in to try the extra point after Bush's 1-yard touchdown run. Snap and holder there. Kick is up. And it is good. Cowboys lead it 7-0. 11:13 left first quarter. Back in 1 minute on the McNeese Sports Network.
I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerson Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
Sector 2. Through wind and rain, storms and sunshine, we're always working hard to earn your trust and confidence. Always working hard to make a difference because we live here too. For service and information, visit Entergy.com. Entergy, the power of people.
Cowboys score first. The 1 yard touchdown run from Chris Bush. See what Richard Dow has down on the sideline, Rich.
Well, guys, interesting that they took as many times as it did. I was standing right there at the goal line. I thought the cut by Chris Bush was a touchdown, but it did take a couple of tries, and with as big as the pile was there, I could see why the head linesman couldn't see it. Interesting note, the shooting section right behind the McNeese bench. And, it's going to be a long afternoon from the shooting section. That's all I know.
Notorious rowdies in the Texas State student section behind the benches there. Cowboys lead it 7-0 on the 1 yard Chris Bush touchdown run, and the very good drive for the Pokes. Versace's kick will be a high kick. It will come to Morris Crosby at about the 12 yard line. Crosby will run to his left. He hit it about the 25. He'll go down at the 26, and that's where Texas State will start. That's our favorite play. High kick that time by Blake. Yeah. Wasn't real deep, but it was effective.
Barron's getting a little competition on his legs.
Darren Jim.
And Kearney's getting close too.
All right, first down for Texas State from their 27. Bradley George is their quarterback. We'll see who starts the tailback. That's Carrington Bush. He's going to be the starter at tailback, replacing Zwingy. Three receivers.
We can vouch for George being capable now.
Toss to Carrington Bush, running right. Running room and more. Into the backfield. First down, crossing the 40, out to the 44-yard line. Carrington Bush, 31 carries, 272 yards, in a relief role of Sam Zwingy. Was very effective that time as they got outside on the Cowboys. Pitch and the shooting body right.
He's lost containment over there on the defensive end.
First down for Texas State at the 44-yard line. George, the big, tall quarterback, put two receivers to the left side.
Well, he looks big, doesn't he?
Carrington Bush is the tailback. Two tight ends in the game now for the Bobcats. And a draw play to Carrington Bush. Running room right up the middle. Big yardage once again. First down across midfield to the Cowboys' 42-yard line. So a toss lead to the right, the draw play up the middle, and they've got about 30 yards.
They got one guard that's supposed to be an All-American. Preseason All-American, they'd be pretty.
Those two plays were too easy. Very, very easy. First down, Texas State. Cowboys 42-yard line. Pope scored on their opening possession. Made it 7-0 with 10:26 left first quarter. George is up under center. Two receivers left. Eye formation behind him. George gives to Bush. Hit. Backed up after a short game. Got up out to the 40 of the Cowboys, maybe the 39. Ryan Smith had a hold of him there, and then needed to get some help from Cody Knox and Biggers. It's a 3-yard pickup, second down and 7.
You know, from the last two or three plays, the Texas State back are pretty good. They're breaking tackle. Yeah. I don't know that there's a hole there, but their backs look pretty good.
Carrington Bush is a 5'10", 182-pound freshman from Wainwright, Texas. Getting some playing time. Wingy out, and he looks like he's earning that playing time. Option play, George will pitch to Bush. He will turn the corner. Got about 5, maybe 6 yards on the carry inside the 35 to about the 33. That's going to lead Texas State a yard, maybe a yard and a half shy of first down yardage.
Now that was probably a shock play. We weren't in position to responsibility on who's got who. And ultimately, down the line, we're gonna probably let George
be the guy that runs the ball if he wants to and make sure we got the pitch. Of course, at 6'6", he can simply fall forward for a couple of yards.
It looks like he wants to run his
right. Third, a yard and a half for Texas State.
You see, they ran that into Smith, too, which is one way to maybe slow him down a little bit.
Bush is hit in the backfield, dives forward for the first down, however. Across the 32, there's a flag down. I believe the Cowboys lined up in the neutral zone and are going to be guilty of an offside penalty there. That's what it looked like to me. And since it was thrown by the linesman at the snap of the ball, I'm going to guess that's exactly what the call is. It's going to be first down either way. Offside against the Cowboys, first down Texas State.
Well, I see angles. I don't see anybody really locking up the guy right now. We're tackling angles, and we're not really in position that well. We just got to get it.
That was only about a two-yard gain on the carry, but they'll take the penalty for 5 yards, and that'll send it inside the 30 to near the 28-yard line. First down, Texas State. Cowboys lead it 7-0 here in the early going. Texas State, on their first possession, are driving into Cowboys territory. I formation behind Bradley George, the receiver to either side. George, back to throw, a little slant pattern, reception made near side, and about 8 yards on the catch, making the grab with Cameron Luke.
You know, that's the only thing you can say right now, and you don't want to ever use his term, but it's soft. You know, we were soft on that corner, on the receiver that time. It was backed off way back. And I think as we get to where we're going to see game speed and feel like we can match up and not have to be so deep, we'll do a little bit better job. But they're still a little too easy for both of them.
Second and two at the Cowboys 20. Texas State leads a couple of people over to the near side of the field now and sends a motion man over here as well. George is up under center. And a pitch to Bush near side. He's hit in the backfield and dropped. Who got there? That is Aline and Smith got there for the Cowboys. He lost a couple of yards back to about the 23-yard line. They stacked everybody up over here on the short side of the field and then ran the toss sweep over here. And there was no place to go. It's going to be third down and about five now.
Well, you know, your first reaction with Smith is he's so great on a pass rush that he sacrifices a lot of runs. But he didn't. He went straight to the boundary and tackled a guy for actually a loss.
Yep. Third and about four and a half now for Texas State. They'll work from the shotgun. Three receivers right, one to the left. From the Cowboys, 23. Low snap, option play far side. Pitch to Bush. Dives and appears to have the first down. He was hit in the backfield, but dove airborne. Reaching out with a football, in fact, and got the first down at the Cowboys 18.
It's just a little too much grass on the perimeter, you know, until one of the mustard hats.
So, yet another first down for the Bobcats. Gives them a red zone scoring opportunity here at the Cowboy 18. Cowboys had a long drive. It culminated in a touchdown. Took about 4.5 minutes off the clock. Texas State has had the ball since that time, and they're deep in Cowboy territory now, first and 10. 7-0 Pokes. George to Bush. Here's his hit. Let's push forward for a couple, maybe three. Oh, no, that's Kennedy who had the football that time. Alvin Kennedy, the other tailback, got three on the carry to the 15. It'll be second down at 7.
The offensive line plays it because the first contact was getting it about 2 yards beyond the ball.
Kennedy remains in the ball game. He's their leading receiver out of the backfield. They like to dump it off to him quite a bit. Bush has been getting the majority of the ball carries. He's Lingy out. Second and 7, Cowboys 15-yard line. George up under center with two tight ends and a receiver to either side. Kennedy the tailback, motion man, coming right to left from the receiver spot. Play fake, they try to go around the other end and they have to cut it back upfield and not much there for Carrington Bush. He is taken down after a 1 yard pickup at the 14-yard line. The Cowboys was a good containment that time by the defensive end.
I said it's kind of selfish of me to say so, but everybody needs a break. But I just wish that Smith was in every down.
Yep.
He's back in now.
So third and it's 6. Excuse me, Johnny.
Big play.
Yeah, it is. Third and 6, Cowboys 14. Texas State has done most of their damage on the ground on this drive so far. See what they do on this third and 6 play. Two receivers left. Bush goes in motion now, left to right.
Low snap. George sets up the throw, and he does, and it's incomplete at about the 6-yard line. Good coverage by the Cowboys. Jonathan Walker there for the folks to hit the receiver Martinez as he made contact with the ball. They'll send in the kicking team and try for a field goal here.
You know, it was overthrown, but I think we had the slant covered anyway.
I think so. Andrew Ireland is the place kicker. Ball will be spotted at the 21-yard line. It'll be a 31-yard attempt from the right half mark.
You know, that's the bend don't break.
Ireland is 4 of 6 in field goal attempts on the year with a long of 48. It was a 31-yard attempt. Bad snap. Great recovery by the holder, and the kick is good. The holder for Texas State had to reach way out to get that. It's Chris McDonald. McDonald reached way out and grabbed it, placed it down. Kick was good. 7-3 Cowboys. We'll take a 1-minute break and be back with more Cowboys football on the Sports Network.
At Nissan of Lake Charles, we're having a September to remember. Remember this, Pathfinder, Quest Van, or Maxima for $24.9. And remember, if you want a car, truck, or van at Nissan of Lake Charles, we're making deals every day. Hi, John Stelly here, inviting you to our pre-owned Super Center Extravaganza and get an 04 Ultima for only $13.9. And remember, if you want a car, truck, or van, we're making deals every day.
That's right, Gabby. We're challenging all other dealers. This is the All-Star Challenge.
That's right. We're challenging those dealers of this new Yukon that's got that new flex fuel engine and gets great gas mileage.
When can I come?
Here at All-Star, we not only challenge you with price, but we challenge you with style.
And don't forget, All-Star is a family dealer where we treat you like a family.
Hey, Papa, what's the trade-in for this?
We are professional grade.
31-yard field goal by Andrew Ireland makes it 7-3 Cowboys. Ireland to kick now. Jones and Tenland are deep. High kick by Ireland. Elric Jones will take it at the 6. He will cross the 10 and the 20. He's tripped up at the 24. Lost the football. And Texas State has it at the 21-yard line. All right, we turned it over to them 6 times last year in Cowboys Stadium. We'll cough it up here.
You know, off the air, earlier we were talking about the turnover margin. Mm-hmm. If you give the other team 2 extra set of downs each game, you don't lose a lot of them.
And if you give it to them at your 21, it makes it that much more difficult.
Well,
Texas State is -4 on the year in turnover margin. The Cowboys +8 on the year. So that has been something that we've done exceptionally well, but not this time. Jones fumbled the kick return.
You leave any team competitive. You know, it doesn't matter what you're running.
Mm-hmm. George will step up under center. It's Kennedy the tailback. Tight end will go in motion left to right. George will pitch. This is going to be a reverse. And they will reverse it to the near side. They'll turn the corner, 20-15, 10-5, out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. Well, they really had the Cowboys peeled off there. At the 3-yard line is where the reverse goes. On the carry was Morris Crosby for Texas State.
So you really don't understand that because it took so long for him to get back over here. You seem like you see that play developing enough to get back over here, and then they started just feeling like punt return.
Yeah, they sealed us off on the wall over here on the near side, and that's what did it. Really gave Crosby a lot of room. So first we go with the Cowboys 3. George up under center, 2 receivers right, 1 to the left. Now he'll go in motion towards the right side. Gives the Bush up the middle. Hit, drop, might have gotten a yard. He's to about the 2-yard line is Carrington Bush. Cowboys have Chris Bush. They have Carrington Bush. Second and goal at the Cowboys 2.
Carrington sounds like one of those people in Dallas.
Yeah.
Dynasty.
Yeah. I guess we're in Texas, so we'll go with Dallas. How's that?
Well, you know, you got to play through this. You know, every team's going to have them. So you just feel like you come out kind of flat, but Texas come out pretty good.
Well, we came out with a great drive to start things, but then gave up a long field goal drive and then turned the ball right over. Second and goal from the 2. Motion man Crosby. Play fake. George wants to throw. Throws back near side, tight end, touchdown. Tight end was wide open. Galen Dunk, who was in blocking and then peeled off and was uncovered.
But you know, Tom, we got no pass rush that time. When we don't get any pass rush on the goal line, your tight end can come across, all the way across, you know.
2-yard TD reception by Galen Dunk from Bradley George, and very quickly, Texas State has taken the lead less than a minute, or just over a minute after their last score. Now 9-7 for the Bobcats. Extra point yet to come. Ireland's kick is up, and it is good. 10-7. Texas State has taken an advantage here. We'll take a one-minute break and be back with more Cowboys football after this on the McNeese Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota, inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerson Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
In Southwest Louisiana, we value the safety of our loved ones and the security of our families. But when this very security is threatened by personal injury due to the carelessness of others, you need to know your rights and where you can go for answers.
We've been helping seriously injured people for over 30 years. As a lawyer with personal injury experience, I understand the value of security and how much we stand to lose by not having it.
Vice Palermo and Veron, your experienced litigation team.
A 2-yard touchdown reception by Galen Dunk from Bradley George. Texas State takes advantage of the Cowboy turnover. Made it to him on the Hope 21-yard line. It's just three plays to get it into the end zone. Bobcats lead it 10-7, 3:49 to go first quarter. Cowboys had a great opening drive and scored a touchdown on it, but really haven't had the football since other than about 5 seconds on that return. Ireland will kick off for Texas State.
We have to answer this with something.
And Elric Jones back deep once again. Ireland kick is a high one. And Elric Jones will take this one at his 7 across the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Breaks it into the open. Broke a tackle. Down he goes at the 42-yard line. So Elric Jones has had two very good kick returns, sandwiched around a very bad one in which he fumbled. He gives the Cowboys a good field position at their 42-yard line. That help?
Yeah. And again, third time. Mm-hmm. Answer that with something. And, you know, this crowd is very excited. And the score 10-7. You know, we had not played good in the score 10-7.
We had a great opening drive, but defensively it's not been...
Well, offensively, Cowboys
field. Yeah, yeah. Sure have it. First down, Cowboys. Peru up under center. Two receivers left. Peru will roll right. Now it's set up and he'll throw over the middle, looking deep for Quentin Lawrence. Incomplete, flag comes down. We'll check the call here. I guess it's going to be pass interference and a Cowboys first down. Lawrence went up for that pass that was slightly underthrown there. He was bumped from behind, and I think we'll get the flag.
So I'm glad we got the flag. I didn't see the interference, but I'm glad we got the flag.
Pass interference. Texas State at 15 yards. It'll move it into Bobcat territory and be a Cowboys first down. Texas State fans not pleased.
But you know, Tom, this is the only fair way to do a pass interference.
Yeah.
You know,
you can't give
pros,
a yard.
The pros throw it 60 yards down, the winner's a 60-yard center.
So first down at the Texas State 43.
Pass interference has really made that Hail Mary play.
A real threat.
Pins and needles.
Two receivers left, Franklin and Lawrence. Now Franklin in motion, a pitch to the left side. Bush trying to turn a corner, does so. Running room, near a first down at the 34-yard line. That's going to be about a yard, maybe a yard and a half shy of first down yardage on first and 10. Receiving body left with Chris Bush. Had a good wall of blockers in front of it.
You know what, Tom? I bet Chris Bush has been told 100 times that one play at the technique where he carried it out to the boundary and everybody says, turn that thing up, turn that thing up. That particular time, it looked like he had an outside play ball. He turned that rascal up with. He'll be better doing that more times than not.
Neely Hubbard is the back now for the Cowboys on second and a yard and a half. And the give will go to Neely Hubbard running right. Dives. Oh, he's stacked up. Appears to have the first down at about the 32. About a 3-yard pickup for Neely Hubbard on his first carry of the ball game, and it is a Cowboy first down. 2:52 left first quarter. Cowboys trail 10-7.
From up here, it just looked like he didn't run the hole. You know, easy for me to say, but it just looked like the hole was to the left.
Cowboys will get Priddle into the ball game now, and the tight end Mangan will lead. Cowboys break the huddle, sending Priddle and Franklin left, Lawrence to the right, Hubbard the tailback behind Peruzzi's up under center. Johnson the fullback in motion, sets up on the left side. Reverse, Franklin, he's going to run, and he'll be taken down right at about the line of scrimmage, might have lost the yard. Peruzzi's trying to block for him there. Nothing doing on the reverse. The reverse got messed up because they almost ran together.
Well, it's the exact same play they ran against us. And somehow I know they had a man safe.
Yep.
He stayed at home. Ours was a little bit quicker than theirs. You know, theirs was slow moving. I guess they meant, now I look back, I think they meant to do it that way.
Lost a yard, maybe even a yard and a half. Second, we'll call it 12 for the Cowboys at their 34. Two receivers left, one to the right. Peru will option. Now he'll turn around. He's in deep trouble, and down he goes, back in the backfield. Looked like it was an option play left, but he suddenly just turned around. I'm not sure.
I thought he had the play, but I think what he thought was the pitch man got too far out ahead of him, you know.
Big loss. Back to the 38-yard line. We'll leave third and about 16, I guess, for the Colts. Now, at this point, you try to get about 6 or 7 yards. You set up Blake versus Jay?
Well, the 30-yard line would make it a 47-yard mm-hmm. field goal, which he's real capable of, and that's what I would say, you know, but and you might get the catch and run, too.
Peru from the shotgun. Here comes the blitz. Peru will throw far side. It is incomplete off the fingertips of Quentin Lawrence. Looks like he had a chance to make the grab and couldn't hang on. It's going to be fourth and long. Cowboys at the 38. We'll see what the Pokes would like to do. You got to anticipate the punting unit's going to come out. And, yeah, here they come.
Yeah, I saw him. I might have a bad angle, but I thought the ball was in his hand.
Looked like it was. He was running directly away from us where he was angling. So it's hard to tell if that was one that he absolutely should have caught or maybe could have caught or whether it was tough. But,
yeah. And that's Matt, one of my big coaches saying the third down. Conversion to third down. He thinks that's one of the most important, which it probably is.
All right, the Cowboys are forced to call a timeout because they didn't have enough players out there for the punt here.
Man, I can smell that barbecue from across the street.
Okay, so you marinate and cook with it?
The ribs you cooked before the game were unbelievable. How do you make barbecue smell like that?
You've got to give me your recipe for grilled fish.
You can use Southern on all of this?
Dad, these burgers are awesome!
After 50 years, any cook who uses Southern barbecue sauce has heard it all. Southern barbecue sauce, the South's finest barbecue sauce since 1957.
Transformer Sector 2.
Through wind and rain, storms and sunshine, we're always working hard to earn your trust and confidence. Always working hard to make a difference because we live here too. For service and information, visit Entergy.com. Entergy, the power of people.
Will Thompson is back deep for Texas State, standing at his 10-yard line. Bershadjay awaits the snap right here at his 48. Good snap. Versus Jay's kick angling to the near sideline. It's going to go out of bounds at about the 10-yard line. Check where they spot it.
No, I think it's beyond. Well, he's slowing down.
He is at the 12-yard line.
Yeah.
13-yard line. That's not bad. Blake versus Jay pins them to the 13. That's where Texas State will start first and 10.
That's not much of a punt, though.
The yardage is not going to look very good, but you're pleased that they're starting inside their 15 anyway. A lot of teams have gotten away from kicking to the top of corners. Some of them are going back to it. Johnny and I both like that. We prefer that to the high kick that you try to get under and down inside the fence.
Especially if you're on one hash mark or the other and you can kick it into that hash and you know you're not going to get a run back on.
George up under center on first down has a pair of tight ends in the ballgame, a receiver to either side, and he will give it to Canada running near side. Canada is going to be pushed out of bounds near the 20-yard line. A good run for Alvin Canada. Got
7 on the play to the Cowboys 20 on second and 3.
I said, knowing what a good athlete Farouk is, I wouldn't doubt if he could do what Tebow does and have to be the poop punter. He's
right.
Tebow come in there and just poop it on the short side of the field, and it's going to be no run back because he doesn't get it off the ground that much.
Second and a long three for Texas State. They'll split two receivers right, one to the left. George works from the shotgun as Carrington Bush checks in a tailback for the Bobcat. Now motion man, left to right. Inside give, Bush. Got a block and got a first down. He got across the 25 to the 27-yard line. And the first down for Texas State. They're running the ball effectively against the county. The offensive line's doing a good job. They're pulling a lot of people. It looks like they're getting a lot of guys ahead of the ball game. From the 27-yard line, first and 10, Bobcats. Late in the first quarter now, 10-7, Texas State leads it. A receiver to either side, high formation behind Bradley George. George takes the snap, a little delayed handoff to Bush. He's hit immediately and taken down for no gain, might have even lost a yard. He gets off the pile first for, or last for the Cowboys. Thibodeau, 56, was credited with the tackle.
Okay, I can't
and
see that.
And that is Trey Bennett over there who was last.
Yeah.
So second down and 11 from now the 26-yard line. We try to let you know who made the tackle once in a while. It's hard to do a lot of the time. Quarter has come to an end. So we will switch sides and come back. Cowboys trail at the end of one, 10-7, back in 1 minute here on the McNeese Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota, inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerstner Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
Papa, it's time for Big All-Star Challenge.
That's right, Gabby. We're challenging all other dealers. This is the All-Star Challenge.
That's right. We're challenging those dealers of this new Yukon that's got that new flex fuel engine and gives great gas mileage.
These new GMC trucks drive so smooth, even us girls love them. An All-Star challenges all other dealers on the price of these new trucks and high trade-in dollars that never go down.
Hey, Papa, what's the trade-in for this?
We are professional grade.
Second and 11 for Texas State from their 26, first play of the second quarter, the Cowboys trailing 10-7.
I think Rich is having trouble with his basement.
Yeah, he must be having trouble.
He said that mic all messed up in his helmet.
Yeah. Now he's holding his little communicator up to his ear to try to hear me, now that the band has quit. George up under center on second and 11 for Texas State. Four receivers in the game, two to either side, and one will come in motion from left to right. George back to throw, little slant pattern, incomplete. In front of his intended receiver, Adrian Thomas, it'll be third and 11.
You know what happened that time when we were backed off on the coverage? And then right before, and then he automatic threw that to the slant.
Mm-hmm.
And then our corner went up and pressed,
Yeah.
And he was right in his face, which was a good play on his part. We'll miss Annie Malone. We're going to be all right. We're getting a little jet lag right now, but we're going to be okay. Just hang with him.
Third and 11, Texas State. Two receivers left, one to the right. Tight end is on the left side. Kennedy is the tailback. Behind George, who now drops into his shotgun. Kennedy standing to his right. Bradley George to throw. Looks over to the near side. He's going to scramble. Now throw to the sideline. And no, he did not get his feet in back. They say he did. Oh, my goodness.
I think we'll have to look at that
one. I think we're going to have to look at that one on the replay. That's going to be a first down, Texas State, as the receiver on the near side, Corey Hickerson, makes the grab. Really didn't think he was inbounds, but they say he was. They were right there looking at it, so I'll give him the benefit
of
the doubt.
That's a bad break for us because a coach gets one challenge, but the play happened on the opposite side of the field for a match, and they won't run it back on the big screen.
I don't think we're going to see the replay of that one. It was a first down at the 42 for Texas State on the completion by George to Hickerson.
Oh, that didn't look like he was in there. Oh, going
inside, Jim Kennedy. Not a lot there. He got a couple, and he's stacked up.
Okay, Bennett right there for the poke stick. Plus that hole is going to be about 3 yards in, maybe just two on the carry for the 40.
They've got Jalen Jackson and Smitty in the ball game, so we're a much better defense than both those guys in the game at the same time.
Second and 10, Texas State. The Bobcats lead it here early in the second quarter, 10-7. But the Cowboys might have stopped them there on third and 11, but nothing doing. And the drive continues now outside the 40. George up under center. Option play far side. In trouble, George. Down he goes, lost on the play. Alleen got him from the backside, but the play was really messed up by the other side. Lundy penetrated over there. So did Bennett. So did Jackson. So some of the guys we were just mentioning really helped create a bad option for Bradley George. He tried to stop it. Dive it back up the middle, but Alleen from the backside wiped him out.
Well, that's right. We don't have replay.
We don't have replay.
Yeah, that's what I, I was trying to say.
We have it on the scoreboard.
I was getting ready to say what Coach B couldn't tell us.
Nope, we don't have it. Third and 10 now, back at the 42. Another big third down for the Cowboy defense here. George up under center, two receivers on either side. Cowboys show blitz, back out. George drops into a shotgun. Blitz comes, throw over the middle. Is it caught? Incomplete. Now the Cowboys might have gotten a break. That one looks to have been caught by the receiver on the far side, Adrian Thomas. They say incomplete, it bounced. I'll take the trade.
Yeah.
I thought that was a catch. I thought the other one was out of bounds. But both of them were very tight calls.
See, we blitzed the free safety and had the had he caught the ball up upright.
Yeah.
It's an over with. There's nobody there to catch it.
It was underthrown for Adrian Thomas. He went down under his belly to try to make the grab and was unable to do so. So the punter is into the ball game. Chris McDonald back deep. It is Charlie Franklin standing at his 15-yard line.
I would think somebody had to have him man-to-man, but they didn't.
Kick is away by McDonald. Franklin awaits this one, has it at his 16. Goes to the right, nothing really over there. He crosses the 20, down at about the 23-yard line.
See, now Texas State is playing good. When you leave a team in the game, you know, and long enough, at home, yeah, they start to effort, start getting better and better and better and better.
There is a timeout on the field, so we'll take the timeout as well. Back in 1 minute on the McNeese Sports Network.
Transformer Sector 2.
Through wind and rain, storms and sunshine, we're always working hard to earn your trust and confidence. Always working hard to make a difference because we live here too. For service and information, visit Entergy.com. Entergy, the power of people.
I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota, inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerson Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
Cowboys trail at 10-7, 13:06 to play second quarter. Let's see if we can get a hold of Richard Dow down on the sideline. Rich, what you know?
A little more serious uplifted after that defensive stop there. You can see it on the faces of the Cowboys. They're a little, they weren't quite into what was going on. They're trying to figure out from the coaches. Looks like we made some switches there on that stand there. Some of the favorite targets of the Texas State fans, well, Freeman and his haircut. That's probably their biggest concern on the sideline. I don't know if you'd ask any of them what the score was, but they do know that Lance has a mohawk.
All right, Cowboys with the first down at their own 23. Peru will step up under center with a couple of receivers to the left side. A pitch to the left. This is Bush trying to turn the corner, and he does. Now he cuts it back up across the 30, has a first down at about the 34. Good run by Chris Bush. Looks like the Cowboys feel they can get some bodies outside of the Texas State defense.
Yeah, well, that looks like a play that Texas State's been running.
Yeah, they're getting bodies. Pulling some closer to that side. It is a Cowboys first down.
If Lance keeps blocking those guys like he wants, he can have a pixie haircut if he wants to get
He could have a haircut like Richard.
Yeah.
Blocking, nobody would make fun of him.
Those people can holler all they want to.
First down folks at the 34. Franklin and Lawrence to the right side. Johnson moves from left to right. Play fake. Peru wants to throw. Has time now. Fires. Far side. Oh, that's it. And it is caught by Franklin, and he's out of bounds. There is no flag, but it won't matter. Carlisle came down with it, even though he was plowed away from the play. Boy, that was a long, long pass, wasn't it?
Yeah, they didn't hear a long time, but that was...
I mean, the defender didn't even look back to the ball.
No, it's running into the boundary.
And that's exactly what you hear. It drives you crazy.
Yeah,
when our corners do that, have their back to the quarterback and don't see what's going on that time.
Yeah, but that was horizontal.
Yeah, it was horizontal toward the sideline. First down at the 43 of Texas State. Good reception by Franklin. We don't have updated stats. I can't really tell you what Peru is on the day. Here's a give to Quentin Lawrence near side. He will cut it upfield at the 40, tries to spin away from the tackler, down at about the 37. That's going to be about a 6-yard gain. Boy, the Cowboys had a really good block over here. Didn't see who laid out the Texas State player, but it was.
Now, Texas State is playing hard. They recover good now. You know, it looks like they had a heck of a play there, and they recovered good. They're just playing hard.
They're playing, the crowd's got them excited. We got them excited. Cowboys trail 10-7. 12 minutes left, second quarter. Peru from the shotgun. Two receivers right, one to the left. Peru will keep. Running room, first down. Moore breaks it out to the 20. He's going to go 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Cowboys. There's Peru.
There it is, Miss Annie. I told you.
Peru jet lag on the zone replay. Kept it himself, ran right, ran through traffic. Nobody saw that he had the football. And Peru takes it in. From, I don't see where the yard marker was. I believe it was the 36-yard line. That's going to be his longest run of the year. A Derek Peru touchdown. Cowboys are back on top. Extra point yet to come. Boy, I'd say Derek Peru is a player. He follows that deep outright, out route with a good throw, and he follows that with a heck of a run.
Versa J to try the extra point here. Connor to hold point. Versa J's kick is no good.
He missed it wide right. 13-10 Cowboys on the Peru touchdown. We'll take a one-minute timeout and be back with more Cowboys football after this on the McNeese Sports Network.
At Nissan of Lake Charles, we're having a September to remember. Remember this, Pathfinder, Quest Van, or Maxima for $24.9. And remember, if you want a car, truck, or van at Nissan of Lake Charles, we're making deals every day. Hi, John Skelly here, inviting you to our pre-owned Super Center Extravaganza and get an 04 Ultima for only $13.9. And remember, if you want a car, truck, or van, we're making deals every day.
Papa, it's time for Big All-Star Challenge!
That's right, Gabby. We're challenging all other dealers. This is the All-Star Challenge!
That's right. We're challenging those dealers of this new Yukon that's got that new flex fuel engine and gets great gas mileage.
When can I come?
Here at All-Star, we not only challenge you with price, but we challenge you with style.
And don't forget, All-Star is a family dealer where we treat you like a family.
Hey, Papa, what's the trade-in for this?
We are professional grade.
Cowboys with a nice touchdown drive. 36-yard run by Derek Peru for the score. Folks have retaken the lead 13-10. Unfortunately, they missed the extra point. And it's a field goal game now, 13-10 Cowboys. And nice to see the offense bounce back, and they really moved the ball very efficiently. Yeah. Johnny.
Hey, this is my favorite play of the game. Here goes Jim and Bennett. Bennett and Turney should be around there somewhere. They go down and get after that switch.
Morris Crosby is the deep man for Texas State versus a kick. There's a good game. Boom. Crosby will go about 5 yards deep, and he'll take a knee. So a touchback. Good kick by Burton. They had a little slight breeze behind him from south to north, but he doesn't necessarily need that. It was a big booming kick for...
No, but it's just a situation where how can a man kick a ball 75 yards and can't kick the extra point?
You know, I mean, I'm serious.
Yeah, I do.
You know,
you just got to focus. You got to... that's what your job is. You got to do it.
And he seems to always get that kick after he does. I bet he went out there and kicked that ball off his shoulder set.
Fundamentals.
First down, Texas State from their 20. George is up under center with two receivers right and one to the left. Now a motion man, that's dunk. And I didn't see what happened there. Looks like they lost a couple yards. George, did he fumble the snap or what happened? I'm not really sure how that happened. See if I can catch the replay here. I was looking in the backfield there for a handoff, and it never came. Back at the 18-yard line is where Texas State is. Tommy McClellan, the interim AD in the booth for saying hello, offering me a drink if I want one. Thank you. No, I'm good. They didn't offer me one. You can go get your own. Second and 12 from the 18. Out of the shotgun is George. George will give it to Bush. Bush is hit quite quickly, but did dive forward for 5 or 6. Thibodeau is there for the post. Also in on the tackle for the Cowboys with Ellison from the tight end spot. Going to set up a third down at about 8 at the Cowboy, excuse me, the Bobcat 22. You know, Thomas, just the people that are right in front of us, I mean, they're we're so excited just a few minutes ago. And we got them excited. You know, we leave them in the ball game, they're going to be excited. And now they're just watching a football game.
Big difference.
Anytime they're on the minus end of the field, they're watching a football game. That's it. Third and 8, Texas State. Two receivers left, two to the right as well. George is up under center. Now he'll back off into the shotgun and call a timeout. Didn't like what he saw. Calls the timeout. 10:23 to go. Second quarter. Cowboys have taken a 13-10 lead. And, well, they have a timeout. We'll take a timeout. Back in 1 minute on the McNeese Sports Network.
Man, I can smell that barbecue from across the street.
Okay, so you marinate and cook with it?
The ribs you cooked before the game were unbelievable. How do you make barbecue smell like that?
You've got to give me your recipe for grilled fish.
You can use Southern on all of this?
Dad, these burgers are awesome!
After 50 years, any cook who uses Southern barbecue sauce has heard it all. Southern barbecue sauce, the South's finest barbecue sauce since 1957.
Hi, I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota, inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerson Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
13-10 Cowboys, 10:23 left, first half. Texas State facing a third and 8 at their own 22-yard line. Sun is just going down now, back on the other side of our broadcast seat here behind us. George in the shotgun, has three receivers left, one to the right. Now he'll send Bush in motion to the right, so five receivers. Cowboys blitz. Pressure, throw near side. Bush makes the reception. He is out of bounds. Where? This is crucial. He's going to be short by a foul. Now he's got the, oh, what a spot.
I don't know.
They gave him a first down. They did, Johnny. Look where he spotted the ball.
Well, not if you're referee.
Oh, yeah. Yep, first down. He got to the 30 along the Texas State bench there. It was a tight, tight spot where he stepped out of bounds.
Well, we're not even, though, because they also gave him that reception over here.
First down for the Bobcat. Well, a stop there would have been huge for the post, though, Johnny. You get the ball back very quickly.
Well, I'll tell you what, we were a tenth of a second away from it back.
Yeah. George in the shotgun, two receivers left. And then Bush in motion to the right. Gives to Kennedy, hit quickly by Valen Jackson. Dropped for a short gain of about 2 to the 32-yard line. Valen Jackson with a stop in the post. Good job by the Cowboy defensive tackle.
See, that's not a lead. That's just a dive play, really. There's no pitch, man.
Yeah, it looks like the zone read play that we run, but there really isn't a read on that. It's just give it to him.
You know, this press box is so enclosed that you don't feel the wind and everything, but I look at the flag, and we've got a pretty good wind at our back.
Yeah,
they do. But I think I'd like to see him punt against the wind down here deep like this. Make this stop, you know.
Second and 8, George option pitch. Gave it to Bush. Got some running room. Out of bounds across the 35. They will spot it at the 36-yard line. That's going to leave them about 4 yards shy of the first down. And another big third down play upcoming for Texas State.
You know, Tom, all the option responsibilities are there. We just make the first tackle, you know. Now, if everybody could get over there, if you could have that one guy get over there and always turn everything back inside, you know, that's almost better than responsibility.
Yeah.
Because you know Bennett's on his way. You know, just hold on for a minute.
Yeah, somebody, Bennett or Smith's going to come flying in there, or Alan Nelson. Or
the Mustard Church,
Mustard Hill. Third and a short 4. George in the shotgun, two receivers right. Steps up, throws near side and threw it away. Wisely did not throw the wide receiver screen. He was well covered, and Thibodeau was coming in from the tackle spot for the Cowboys. George just threw it away, incomplete, and a punting situation.
You know, that time a lot of people make good plays because it stopped and went to the screen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even the down linemen. You know, we had one or two guys chasing the quarterback, but everybody was backed up because they read the screen. That's a good play.
McDonald will punt. He has about the shortest deep snap on the punt. It's less than 10 yards they give him.
But he gets a good punter.
He's a good punter. Franklin is deep for the poke, standing at his 21.
This is a hotbed of football talent down here. We're right between Austin. Oh, nearly blocked, but good kick.
Anyway,
and he's also a one-step punter.
Yes, he is. Franklin starts at his 20, steps out of bounds, right at the 20-yard line. That was a good kick. There is a flag down. Uh-oh, I wonder what this could be.
I don't know.
It looks like they're going to call illegal procedure, I think is what I saw. A false start against Texas State. The signal it looked like he gave. I'm not coming out to the referee. The linesman on the far side.
Let's make it important for him to spot the ball. Oh, he's got it down.
Yeah.
For us to be able to know it, if it is to our advantage, what we want to do with it.
I think we'll make him kick it again, don't you?
Yeah, I think so.
That was a good kick.
That's on behind the 20. I think any time behind the 20, I'd make a kick again.
Franklin, who caught the ball at about the 18, right along the sideline, basically got one step in before he stepped out of bounds at the 19. So I think we'll push him back to their 31 and make him kick again.
No, we put our offense on the field.
Yeah, we sure did. So we'll start it on 19. 9:20 to go. First half. Cowboys leading.
No, we're gonna put five on the end of it.
Oh, we can do it that way.
Yeah,
now.
That's right.
Right. Yes, we sure can. You know, I want you to write at halftime.
Hmm?
Southwest Texas 100 times.
No, I want Texas State 100 times.
You don't even know the assignment.
Yeah.
You keep going. Well, I did good over in Lafayette. I won't say that school's name again because I'll get it wrong. First down, Cowboys out of the shotgun. Peru. He's back to throw. Has time. Goes over the middle. Hits Brittle. Broke the tackle. He's to the 30, 35, and taken down at about the 38-yard line. Good run after the catch by Emmanuel Brittle. Crossing pattern left to right, and he drags tacklers with him.
You're just lucky we played Southern Utah and South Dakota, not one of the North.
That's the Cowboys' first down at the 39. 9:09 to play, first half. Folks on top by three. This is our first possession with the lead all game, Johnny.
Yeah. I want to see them get Quentin Long to catch, you know.
Yeah.
I think it's important to get him to catch, you know, after that play a while ago.
A give to Todd Penland, who was a step away from breaking that one for big yardage. Instead, he tripped up after his short pickup. Got maybe three out to the 42.
You know, Penland is the best explosion from the stance of any of them. You know, boom, he's there.
It is a three-yard pickup to the 42, second down and seven. I really feel confident in our offense moving the football against these guys. They have moved the ball fairly well against us, particularly in the early going. That's the worrisome part, and we're minus one in the turnover game.
You know, we saw George throw 30 completions again a year or so ago, so keeping him off the field is a big thing, too.
Peru to throw, and he hits Quentin Lawrence, who's down on his knees as he makes the grab across the 45. Look at where they spot this. It's going to be at the 46-yard line, so it's a very short gain. Just four.
That's probably a game effect there.
And it'll be third and three at the Cowboys 46. It's a big play. And it is.
Yep.
Hubbard will check in now as tailback for the Cowboys for this third down and three.
The only good thing, real good sign right now, is we're not playing that good and we have a lead.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we're going to come out the second half, get things right, and play good.
Peru shotgun. Peru keeps. He's in trouble. He'll dive, and he's near a first down. Well, Peru was trying to give it to Hubbard, then kept it, and then was in all kinds of traffic and dove forward. He's close to a first down, depends on the spot of the ball.
But Tom, how many times have we seen the ball on the ground? Never.
Never.
Peru just takes charge of that play. You know, the other guy didn't take the football.
Right. Right.
Peru just, and of course, it hurts his rushing. But, I mean, he's taking charge. The ball is never on the ground.
That was a great job by Derek Peru, and he's got the first down. We get the signal. It's first down, Cowboys, from the Pope 49-yard line. 7:31 left first half. Cowboys on top 13-10.
Derek Peru makes so many plays you don't...
Our quarterback
makes so many plays you're not familiar with. Of course, he and Mark Runtno are 3.5 or better, 4.0 shooting. So,
You know how I feel about the cerebral part of the game.
Threw up under center.
Quick drop.
Close
it is.
Land.
It's caught. Lawrence has it, and he's off to the races. 20-15-10. Five. Touchdown, Cowboys. Here's the man.
We've been waiting for that one, haven't we?
Quentin Lawrence on the slant, and bye-bye. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Tom, if there's any way we could describe that play to the folks back home, once he caught, he split him and just outran. You know, both of that with angles on him and just outran. We've been waiting for him to get the ball like he did Georgia Southern.
Outran them by a wide, wide margin.
And we just got through saying we want him to get another reception. Well, I think he's all right.
I think he's fine. First to Jay, we'll get another extra point try here. Snap and hold her there. Kick is up, and it is good. Blake first to Jay nails this one. Cowboys lead it 1-10. We'll pitch.
In Southwest Louisiana, we value the safety of our loved ones and the security of our families. But when this very security is threatened by personal injury due to the carelessness of others, you need to know your rights and where you can go for answers.
We've been helping seriously injured people for over 30 years. As a lawyer with personal injury experience, I understand the value of security and how much we stand to lose by not having it.
Vice Palermo and Veron, your experienced litigation team.
That's right, Gabby. We're challenging all other dealers. This is the All-Star Challenge.
That's right. We're challenging those dealers of this new Yukon that's got that new flex fuel engine and gets great gas mileage.
When can I talk?
Here at All-Star, we not only challenge you with price, but we challenge you with style.
And don't forget, All-Star is a family dealer where we treat you like a family.
Hey, Papa, what's the trade-in for this?
We are professional grade.
20-10 Cowboys, 7:07 to play, first half. Quentin Lawrence with, I believe, a 51-yard reception on the slant from Derek Peru. That'll be another touchdown pass for Derek and another touchdown receiving for Quentin, who had a two-touchdown game at Southern Utah.
It could have been a five-mile reception because if Vince wouldn't have stopped it, nobody would have ever caught him, I promise.
Boy, he looked good that time.
Boy, he looked great. We were waiting for that. We said we need to get another reception so he can really get a little accomplished.
First to Jay is set to kick, and Johnny's favorite play.
Yeah, I'd love to watch the guys break the wind. I don't think this team sets up a wind, so it's hard to,
right.
Yeah.
Hard to break what they all set up. First to Jay's kick is a long one, and that will drive Crosby 8 yards deep. He'll take a knee.
Now look at those kicks.
Wow. That's great. There is a bit of a breeze behind it, but those are just booming kicks.
Well, I'm still upset that he kicked the ball almost all the way through the upright and not on the 3-yard line.
All right, Johnny, we've got three touchdowns in the game. Two of them have been on very long plays. One, the 36-yard run by Peru, and now a 51-yard reception to Lawrence. Big plays. He hit a lot of big plays last year. Before we're getting some this year, that's great.
But Derek Peru always makes a play to keep the drive alive. You know, he's always in there somewhere.
George to throw, quick drop, near side for Bush, makes the grab and is wrestled down by Marcus Brown at about the 26-yard line. The second and four for Texas State.
You know, Tom, let's add this again for everybody. We have a crew in the Southland Conference. We've merged with the Big 12 Conference. So our crew, every time we have a game, we'll have two members of the Big 12 Conference. And the same thing on a Big 12 game. We'll have two members of the Southland Conference. So it's a pretty good win-win merger.
Second and four at the 26. Two receivers left for George and a pair of tight ends in the ball game now. Bush is the tailback. We have two Carrington Bush hit in the backfield and dropped for a loss. Good penetration by the Cowboys. Lundy is there. So is Lindy for the Cowboys. So Lindy coming up from the backfield. Sean Lindy from the tackle spot. And a loss of two back at the 24-yard line. It's going to be third and six. Peru having a good night passing. 6 of 8, 113 yards, and a TD. He's also the Cowboys' leading rusher. 5 carries, 52 yards in the TD.
Well, I'd say with the first three plays of the game, they had the football. They looked like the Green Bay
Packers. I know it. Third and six. Another big third down play for Texas State. They're at their 24-yard line. Out of the shotgun with three receivers stacked on the right side. George will roll that way. He'll be pressured, and he'll throw. Oh, a nice grab for a first down. Morris Crosby at the 36-yard line, stretching out for that one and diving, got his hands on it, kept it off the ground. I think George is a little bit faster than he looks. He just looks like a big old guy, but he outruns some of the perimeter rushers.
Yeah.
That was a fine catch by Morris Crosby. It really was. And it's a bobcat first down. And a big one for them. The Cowboys, if they'd have gotten the ball back very quickly, there could have really turned this game very one-sided. And look at the crowd. 20-10 Cowboys, 5:35 left first half. They're not excited. There's a lot of folks here.
Yeah.
George up under center. Flips. They'll throw it into the flat. It's caught by Kennedy, who breaks one tackle, pushes outside, and is out of bounds after about a 7 or 8 yard gain. Well, they threw to the right guy. A little dump off to Kennedy on the far side as the blitz was coming in. And George hits a little safety valve there, who got eight. The only negative, we were in the right place. We didn't make the tackle. Mm-hmm. We had the tackle for, even if he hit the hot receiver, we could make the tackle for no gain. Kennedy with the reception in the 8 yard gain leaves a second and two in the Texas State 44. That was a blitzing more tonight than we've seen in the past so far on the year.
Look at this, we got Trips over here.
Trips stacked on the right.
Yeah.
On second and two, George in the shotgun. Bush is the tailback. Cowboys jump, flags are down. They'll give the ball to Bush. He will get the first down, and they'll take it into Cowboy territory at the 48-yard line. They get the option of taking the penalty yardage or the run yardage, and I think the run yardage is a yard farther than the penalty yardage. So
yeah,
Carrington Bush will get a 6-yard gain, and they'll reach Cowboy territory.
But I'll bet you, Tom, well, you're not supposed to bet, but I'll guarantee you, when three guys jump, the quarterback gets them.
Oh, yeah, you know there was heart count or a head bob or whatever. The Cowboys have been somewhat vulnerable to that over the past couple of years. They've had some aggressive defensive linemen who get kind of into a rut on the snap count.
Yeah, when quarterbacks get in a rut.
Yes, they do.
When that quarterback, everything's on the
suit. Our first and 10, Bobcats, Cowboys 48. Hope lead is 20-10. Option play far side. Now George is going to step out of it and throw. He's got his tight end. He can't hang on to the football. A tight end on the near side, had his hands on it, that's Andrew Brooks. Yeah, couldn't keep his mitts on it, would have had a pretty nice gain, although Trey Bennett was right there ready to nail him.
Well, that's just great. For the next, every time the tight end crosses the field from now on, Trey Bennett needs to unglue it.
Yeah,
because of that throwback pass earlier in the game.
Second and 10 from the Cowboys 48.
Keep cleaving it.
From the shotgun, George. Two receivers left, one to the right. Takes the snap, and inside give. Kennedy in trouble, is taken down for a loss. Back near midfield. Who penetrated? I think it was Smith was there to mess up the play. Bennett,
and he gets back on the play.
Bennett and Nelson wrapped him up, lost a yard. Yard and a half, back to the 49. Going to be third and a good, solid 11.
In that machine that Dakota said it was a machine, Smith and Bennett are cylinders.
Yes. Well oiled. Third and 11. Shotgun for Bradley. Two receivers left, one to the right. Takes the snap, drops the throw. Has time, throws near side, and throws it behind his intended target. Incomplete. And it'll be fourth down. Corey Stott was the intended receiver, reaching down the near side. He cut it on a post. The pass went on an out route.
But you know, Smith is that can alter the game and not get a sack. Because they're not throwing any deep routes because they don't have time. Smith is a step away on every route. And so he got rid of the ball. You know, he threw the wrong area.
McDonald to punt. Very short distance back to him, less than 10 yards. Franklin is the punt returner standing at his 11.
Oh, kick is blocked. We've got it. And it's going to go out of bounds to midfield.
The short, deep snap on that play has given the Cowboys the chance to come in off the corner. They nearly got it earlier, and they got it that time. We'll see if we can figure out who got it. Who blocked it? All right, we'll figure out who that...
You know, the punter, McDonald, he has no form at all. He just grabs the ball and kicks.
Yeah.
So, you know, old McDonald doesn't have any form.
It's Brian Harvey, number 31, who got it for the Cowboys, according to the coaching staff right next to it. First down, folks, 4:10 to play in the half. From the 49-yard line, Peru in trouble. Taken down on the sack. It was a
That was a screen over here. You see two guards, in the back away over here?
Yep.
That was a screen over here. And usually what happens on a screen is 1001, 1002 go, they're 1000 and go. Yeah. It let them come through too quick.
There was a play fake involved as well. And I think because of that, Peru didn't see what was going on. All right, we got an injured Southwest Texas player. Oh, I said it again. It's Texas State. That's been about 4 years. I ought to be over it. Of course, it's been, you know, a decade for Northeast and for USL, and I still make that one. But check and see who the injured Bobcat is. You know, I'm almost with the championship series. I'm almost the Division I AA. I'm almost out of that. The injured Bobcat State player is Morgan Taylor, one of the defensive backs. He's not putting any weight on his foot as he comes to the sideline. It's going to be second and long for the Cowboys. They lost four on the play, back to the 45. You know, the coach is making sure his job is secure. He's got about 11 or 12 players on the bench that have their uniform on, but they don't have their shoulder pads. Second and 14. Cowboys are at their own 45. Peru from the shotgun now, has Bush standing beside him. Inside give by Penland, who's trying to turn the corner far sideline. He's got the corner, and he's got about 10 on the carry inside Bobcat territory at the 44-yard line. That's going to leave a third and, well, about three as they place it at the 43.
You know, before the game on the Chiefs to victory and everything, I included the thoroughbreds and the talent and everything. That was all talent. That was all Penland. You know, he just outran people. The play looked horrible.
It's a little misdirection kind of play to the opposite side of the field. And Penland was easily able to turn the corner. Sets up a third. We'll call it two from the 43. Bush is back in the game, standing beside Peru in the shotgun. Cowboys with two receivers left, one to the right. Peru takes the snap, gives to Bush. Pushing forward near a first down. He needs two, and that's about what he has.
It's going to be
very, very close.
But it's a four down. I mean, we're going to go for
it. Yeah, we certainly could go for it if we don't have it, and we'll just check the spot of the ball. We need to get just inside the 41.
I'm not so sure he has it if the hashes are right.
Yeah.
It's right on the hash, though. Right on it. He might, maybe the...
They'll bring the sticks out. We'll get a...
I miss that yellow line that they have on the TV.
Yeah, how come we don't get one of those live? Let's see if Richard Dow can give us a good look at this one. Rick, what do you see?
It's going to be very close. It looks like about the front 2 inches of the football was over for the first down from the way we're looking at it, right behind the stick where the side judge goes. Oh, going to miss it by an inch. Going to miss it by an inch.
All right, it'll be fourth and an inch, according to Rich.
Now, Rich, that's crazy. Hey, you said 2 inches. I mean, you know, just the fact that you're 50 yards away.
And
you should be able to find
it. I like the detail that he gave us. He said, this is going to be close.
You know, they're bringing the teams out there for a reason.
That way,
you know, because it's close.
Well, y'all just got through giving us the fact that the sun's going down and Freeman has a
Well, he can give us insights like those. Why can't he come up big when we need...
Fourth and 2 inches. Here is the fourth down play for the Cowboys. Peru up under center.
Oh,
and the Cowboys move. We jump. Tight end. Cowboys move, and Texas State fans celebrate. Post will be forced to punt it away now.
You know, and I bet the play was right up the middle, and it wasn't, the tight end didn't have a block.
You know what happened? I watched the replay of it. Their defensive end moved first. And he didn't just give one of those. He actually moved. He was moving in as if it was a quarterback sneak, and he moved quickly. He didn't come across, so there's no chance of it being against Texas State there. So fourth down and five, and first and Jay into punt.
I feel like that takes 3 points away from you, really.
Yep, very possibly could. Clock runs now with 3:05 to play in the half. Cowboys leading 20-10, and they're punting it away from Texas State 46.
Let's go down there and get the fumble.
The snap, first to Jay's kick to the far sideline and short, and it's going to go out of bounds outside the 20. That hurts. Outside the 20. We'll check where they spot it. Blake got that one off the side of his foot. It's at the 26-yard line. So, the exchange there really hurts. He did a great job earlier. Just nailing one to the top of the corner, but this time, out.
Well, he's going to have about a 20-yard front average.
Yeah. First down, Texas State from their 26.
Prior to that one, he had one punt for 25 yards.
Yeah, he'll be under 20.
Yeah,
but that one was from the 46 to the 26, so that's a 20-yarder.
And that's not even inside the 20.
First and 10, Texas State. Three receivers right, 2:48 to go in the half.
And they have two timeouts, just they need to use them here late. George in the shotgun, takes the snap, drops the throw, sets up a screen. He's got Canada far side and not much there. Darren Miner was there to make the stop after about a two-yard gain.
You know, Tom, I've had the feeling now, and I know you probably have the same thing, is we're getting in position a lot better now. We're seeing what we're seeing, which leads me to believe maybe a lot of things they'd not have done on offense they hadn't done in film, prior film. But that, like that one, we got in position right here.
Second and eight, no huddle. George in the shotgun. Train coming by here. George back to throw. Halftime throws over the middle. It's up in the air. Incomplete. Somebody got a hand on it for the Cowboys. I think it was Cody Knox, 33. He did so. And put it up into the air. And was hoping with it flying around up there that maybe the Cowboys could step underneath it and make the catch. Didn't happen. It'll be third and eight.
You know, so much coaches can do during the ball game. Coach Clark Avery and Coach Rollins are making some good defensive adjustments now to get us in position. Yeah. And after the initial, where they're doing so well and they've done so, Coach Avery and Coach Rollins have been doing that all year. Though.
Third and eight, Texas State from their 28. And a whistle and a flag. They move. That helps. A false start against the Bobcats. We give them a third and 13.
You know, actually, we have a tendency, and I don't know if it's a tendency or that's all we can do, is give the coordinators, you know, the credit. And, you know, they got each of coordinators, well, they got a bunch of coaches underneath them.
Right.
You know, so you got to give Jake Morrison and Zach Ronson and all that bunch of credit, too, you know, and the same way offensively. Matt, I guess, handles a lot of the offense. Mm-hmm. So, They just want to name all the coaches, you know. We can't do that.
Third and 13. Back to throw George. Pressure. He'll step up, and now he'll flip it to the tailback. He's got running room in front of him and has the first down and more. Down he goes at midfield. That was Harrington Bush on the reception. George was in trouble. Dumped it to his tailback wide open spaces. First down Bobcats. That really hurts. 2:03 to go in the half there. Near midfield.
That's just too much time for him to sit back there and be able to do that. And
he's got to be doing a pretty good job, I guess, in the offensive line. So first down, Texas State at their 47. A receiver to either side. George has.
Obviously, we don't have Smith in there again.
Push the tailback behind him. No motion man, left to right, that's Kennedy. Option near side. Bush is hit in the backfield and pushed out of bounds. And may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage and gotten a yard. Good job by the Cowboys reading the option that time. And
yeah, it was in there. Yeah, you know what happened? Smith made the quarterback hit, and he's after the boundary made it back.
A yard gain for Harrington Bush. Clock stopped as he went out of bounds with 1:43 to go in the half. Second down and 9, Texas State.
You see, I think this is important for the team, somebody to go into half.
Right.
And I want us to go in there with a 10-point lead.
At least.
Yeah, at least.
We had a moment ago a chance to add to it in their territory on 4th and inches. Three receivers left, stacked and tripped. George will roll that way, and he'll set up to throw, and he will. He'll hit the receiver, who will try to get the sticks, and I think he did as he goes out of bounds. Making the grab for Texas State. It's Delbert Current.
Yeah.
A wide receiver. Did he get the first down?
No. I got the stick going on or something. Or it just happens to be big because the receivers are right there in the same area. And then one of them just seems to get over.
They're going to leave it shy of the stick by a half a yard. Third and a foot. Clock stopped with 1:35 to go in the half. Time we need to stop here, leading 20-10. We're near.
They're going to milk the play clock down.
Five on the play clock as they break the huddle. Up under center is George. Crosby in motion. Lost the ball on the snap. And he got it back, but he lost about a half a yard on the play. And it's going to be fourth. Good solid yard to go for Texas State. They'll call a timeout with 1:26 to go.
You know, I thought the clock expired, but I'm glad it didn't.
Yeah.
You know, they got the down over.
It would have been third and 5.5 instead. Yeah. Now it's fourth and a yard and a half. Texas State calls the timeout. In this ball game, the Cowboys got the football first. They marched right down the field and scored on a Chris Bush 1-yard TD run.
Transformer Sector 2. storms and sunshine, we're always working hard to earn your trust and confidence. Always working hard to make a difference because we live here too. For service and information, visit Entergy.com. Entergy, the power of people.
That's right, Gabby. We're challenging all other dealers. This is the All-Star Challenge.
That's right. We're challenging those dealers of this new Yukon that's got that new flex fuel engine and gets great gas mileage.
When can I come?
Here at All-Star, we not only challenge you with price, but we challenge you with style.
And don't forget, All-Star is a family dealer where we treat you like a family.
Hey, Papa, what's the trade-in for this?
We are professional grade.
They gotten out of bounds almost on every reception. Backfield moves out now. Two tight ends. Bush is the tailback for Texas State. George, option. He will keep and dive, and we'll see what the spot is. That's what it is all dependent on, and it's going to be very, very close. They need to get to the Cowboys 43. And once again, let's call on Richard Dow. No, we don't need to. It's Cowboys football.
We've seen Bradley George fumble quite a few snaps here tonight. Actually, not necessarily fumble them, but the exchange of he and his center have caused some problems there. The other basic problem is you've seen Brian Smith not being able to rush in as quickly tonight. They've been talking about a little bit of the county and some of the misdirections really kept the defensive ends at bay, and you hear him talking about it on the sidelines. Footwork being the biggest part of trying to stop the option drive by Texas State.
If the Cowboys can get a late score here with the ball at their own 43-yard line, first and 10, hopefully 20-10. Peru shotgun, little dump-off pass. Elric Jones has it, and running room, midfield 45. 40, cuts back at the 43, gets some blockers, 30, 35. He's down at the 21-yard line. Big run for Elric Jones on the reception, a minute 8 to go. It'll be a Cowboy first down deep in Texas State territory.
You know, Tom, what my theory is on what Richard's talking about is I would suspect that they have not been under the center very often this year. And that cut the rush down of Smitty by decreasing his angle. He's got a different angle than when he's back in the shotgun. He's got a dead shot run. And I bet you that has something to do with them not getting the center snap because they want to be a shotgun team.
First down, Cowboys at the 21 of Texas State. The clock runs to 58 seconds to go. Peru in the shotgun, two receivers left. One to the right. Inside gives Bush. Bush to the right side. This is the pile. Down to about the 16-yard line. 46 seconds left. And a timeout has been called by the Cowboys, I do believe. That'll leave us one left with 46 seconds to go. It'll be second down and five from the Texas State 16. Judge Owen was always... He always likes to give the kicker a timeout.
Yeah, save one for the kicker.
The other 2 weeks you can have, and then the kicker gets one.
Hi, I'm Philip Tarver for Lake Charles Toyota, inviting you to come in for a first-class shopping experience. We have a vast inventory and a professional sales staff to meet with you in a comfortable, open environment. Your service experience begins with a professional, courteous welcome and continues through valet delivery upon completion. Our unique amenities include complimentary beverages, child's play area, a large waiting lounge, and a gift shop and wireless internet. We all work very hard to give you the first-class service you're worthy of at Lake Charles Toyota, Gerson Memorial, south of I-210, where we know you by your name.
Even a field goal would be very, very big right here. Cowboys lead it 20-10. Bush is the tailback on second and five from the Texas State 16. Peru is up under center. Drops the throw, rolls right. He's in trouble, will throw, and it is intercepted. Peru made a mistake there. He sure did. He was looking for Jordy Johnson down the right rail.
Yeah.
And he was well covered by the linebacker over there, and he wanted him to go deep and tried to throw it deep, but didn't get it over top of the linebacker. It made the interception on the catch. It is Marcus Clark.
He should have lofted the bone.
Yeah, he did
loft it.
Yeah, I see it on the replay. Well, that hurts a lot.
And then, of course, after the start, I think you should have run the ball.
Yeah,
and especially knowing that
or thrown it away.
Yeah, that, because he's a fullback anyway. It's not a receiver that's 6'3".
So with 38 seconds left, Texas State will have its first and 10 at their 2-yard line.
We're winning 20-10. We got them backed up to the 2-yard line, and we hadn't played the best football of the year right now. So things are all right.
George up under center. will run it himself. He'll kill the clock here. He'll get it out to about the 4-yard line. 33 seconds to go.
I promise you, this is what they're going to do. It's a pre-game.
Oh, absolutely. And the Cowboys may not make them take another snap. You may just go to the dressing room with a 20-10 lead. Boy, it could have been more.
Yeah.
He threw the late interception deep in Texas State territory. And the only turnovers in the ball game are Cowboy turnovers.
Well, the only guy would have accepted something to do that would have been terrific.
Yeah, he played so well.
He's so up on it.
Yeah. All right, that will be the final play of the second quarter. The half will come to an end. Cowboys on top 20-10. We will take a timeout. We'll be back with halftime right after this on the McNeese Sports Network.